Dub C Mac 10 and Ice Cube.
Ice Cube, I've heard, but I've never heard of Dub C Mac. I'm sorry, man. I'm not from Cali.
Yeah.
I'm from Cali, man.
It's a dude called CJ Mac, and he was part of the group, and he right there. That's what I'm just telling you, but you don't
know. So we got a celebrity right here, right now?
Not a celebrity, That's his guys. Okay. In our city in LA, everybody know him.
Looking far from rich, so the luck spitting nothing but game. When I come up on a dinner stash, just in case I got smacked. But it's kinda unlikely I trip. I'm under less pressure since we come up on the grip. I'm hitting switches in the black toe. Four gates in the truck and a bag full of silver.
So you can see how a G-shaped feels in a 63. Down the shore. Now watch him see so down the shore, trying to ditch the law.
How about this? You want to interview him? Because I do not know who that is.
You gotta do it. You already set up. Just go right there. He's
which
cool.
One, which one is it? With the red?
Right here. One right there. Yeah. It's good. Man, it's good, man.
Man, I just holla at three girls down there. You know what I'm saying? Another man's body ain't nothing crazy to me, so I'm going to do it.
Tell you, look, go get him right now.
I'm going to ask. Cool. Is it cool if I ask Ice Cube question?
Nah, that's CJ Mac. Hey, just go over there. You ask him about Ice Cube, and he can tell you better.
Go right in. Ladies and gentlemen, we're about to get into Ice Cube's partner, right?
So that's Ice Cube's partner?
Yeah, that's his good friend.
I bet. So I'm about to go crazy. You know what I'm saying? I'm a little nervous because this is a little bit of a celebrity. You know what I'm saying? Hey, anybody would, man. I'm not really up there yet. You know what I mean? But I'm going to go. Hey, how you doing, CJ Mac? Hey, man. First of all, my name is
Lloyd Manny.
What's happening, Lloyd Manny? 100, bro. All
right, so my boy over there was telling me that you used to work with Ice Cube, right?
Ice Cube, Dub C, Mac 10, everybody on the West Coast.
All right, cool, man. So first of all, man, I want to say, how long were you working with Ice Cube back in the day?
Oh, bro, like years, like 20 years, bro. Oh, yeah.
So, all the way back. Okay, I had that first question in my mind was, like, seeing boy, was that movie again? Yeah, Straight Outta Compton. So is from watching that movie, was that true the way that it looked?
A lot of it, I mean, that was their interpretation. If Suge would have told it would have been a little bit different probably, but from their side, you know, from their perspective, that was true. As far as Straight Outta Compton, Boys in the Hood, that was a pretty good story of certain sections of the city, yeah. Yeah.
So damn, man, that must have been a struggle living up in Cali back in the day, you know what I'm saying? So now that it is the way it is now, has it calmed down ever since?
Nah, it's just that it happens so much now that the media don't talk about it no more. So it's still going on, but the media just don't cover it no more.
Okay.
So it's the same. It's just, it might even be worse.
So what was the song that you've done with Ice Cube?
I work with them on several things, man. On Dub C's album's artist by the name of Dub C. He's like Ice Cube's right-hand man, even when they're on tour right now. If you saw like the Up in Smoke tour back in the days, or if you Google it, you'll see Dub C do a lot of crip walking. Like, he's kind of like the person that put it out. And I did a documentary with him called Sea Walk, It's a Way of Living.
Right.
And then I done a bunch of songs with him, Cube, Mac 10. I used to be signing Mac 10's label. who was up under Ice Cube.
So as you know, like Hawaii people here is very influenced from the people from Cali, because the people from Cali always come down here, right? So for the, you know what I'm saying, for the people that wants to be gang members here in Hawaii, does that make sense?
That don't make sense, especially if it get to the point of you killing your friends.
Right.
You know, you're killing people you grew up with and all that. If they take it to that level, then that's when it's not cool. You know what I mean? Like, everybody got their tribal thing or whatever, but if you're going to take it to a point to start hurting somebody you grew up down the street from because somebody in L.A. was doing it, and they shouldn't even be doing it, trying to stop doing it, then it just don't make sense.
Right, right, right.
Hey, that's facts, man. Hey, for all the gang members that is here in Hawaii, stop that shit. Because we got a real man right here, you feel me, that been through that shit, you feel me?
I mean, raise your kids and do what you're supposed to do.
Right, right, right.
This is the island.
Get you some gray hair, man. That's the new cool, man. Get you some gray hair, man.
Hey, it's the island of paradise, man. We got to live paradise ways, you feel me? So what are you doing here in Hawaii, man?
I'm here with my family, relaxing, man, and enjoying y'all's city, man. It's beautiful, man. I love it here. I love it here. I ain't had nothing but fun, except for this hike I went on today. Damn, they killed me. But other than that.
Hey, don't tell me it's Diamond Head, is it?
No. We went to something realer than that, man. Okay. We went to something, had me all in the mud and in the bushes today, man. I ain't think I was going to make it up out of there. But it's beautiful, man. It's a beautiful place, man. I'd love to be able to come here more.
All right. Hey,
yeah. Hey man, I want to say thank you. It's an honor and a pleasure to have an interview with you, man.
One love, man.
You got a shout-out for it. You want to say anything to Ice Cube out there? Hopefully he sees this.
Oh, man, Cube, man, check him out, man. You got good people out here, man. They treat you real well. Everybody friendly and nice, man. And I love it out here, man.
Hey, so we're a new breed. We're Micronesians. We're called Micronesians here, and we're a new breed, right? So, you know, people hate on us, you know what I'm saying? So, like, hey, I appreciate that, man. So we're just trying to showcase ourselves out here and trying to show people, like, we're different. You know what I mean?
All right, 100, man. When I'm CJ Mack, I'm, you know, player. It's my pleasure to be in the company of y'all, man, and thank y'all for, man, giving me a couple minutes.
Hey. Right. Hey, thank you very much, man. I appreciate it, man. Much love, man. Hey, enjoy your guys' vacation. Thank you, guys.
Yeah. One more thing, man. Me and Dub C got a podcast coming out called Real Recognize. And that's where you gonna get your facts and a whole bunch of your stuff from right there, man. We're coming to LA culture.
Hey, honestly, I love real people, man. So is there any possible way I can get on that podcast?
Well, you know what, man? You just get my Instagram or whatever and get at me, man. All right,
I got you.
We do what we do.
Yeah.
All right, brother. Well, thank y'all, man.
Hey, thank you.
All right, love.
I mean, it's a lemonade that has a kick to it. You know what I mean? So my son, it's his recipe. You know what I mean? So it's made with all natural ingredients, and I want to know that you guys let me know what you're thinking. I hope you like it. You know what I mean? Right. Hope you love it.
Ah, first of all, man, right when you stood up in front of me, I was like, damn, this motherfucker's tall as shit. How tall are you, man?
I'm tall, man. I'm 6'4". You know what I'm saying? 6'4".
Okay. You know? I mean, man, I'm a normal guy in size. You know what I'm saying?
Cool.
So
that's cool. Okay. I love it.
All right, so what you pouring up, man?
Pouring up, it's going to be Kalon's Kick of Creation, you know what I'm saying? So, it's like I said before, it's made with all natural ingredients, you know what I mean? It's lemon, limes, honey, and if you like it, you know what I mean? I hope you guys come back and let me know what you think.
So,
you know what I mean?
How much you charge for this?
This is $20 a cup, and it's very refreshing, and it's worth every penny of it, because it's made with love, you dig?
Right. $20, hopefully it's worth it, babe. Me, I'm a straight up guy.
Always.
This tastes like it has lemon and pineapple in it.
Okay, it does. Those are two of the ingredients. What else?
Damn, I hate myself because I don't really know flavors that well, but I know lemon and pineapple for sure. But yeah, you get a form of.
But we got limes in there as well, you know what I'm saying? And then we also got honey, like I said before.
Okay, honey. Yeah, there you go.
And I mean, so that's the sweetener of it, you know what I mean? Right. And that basically sums it up for this batch, you know what I mean? So
hey, so I wanna ask you a personal question, man. So do you know anything about the Micronesian culture here?
Let me turn this down for you. Say that one more time.
Do you know anybody that is Micronesian here on the islands of Oahu?
I know a couple, actually, man. You know,
in your opinion, man, what do you think about those kind of people, man?
Those kind of people. Okay. Exactly. You know what I'm saying? Let me tell you what I think. I think they are people. They are beautiful people. You know what I'm saying? They are warming. They're welcoming. You know what I mean? And they humble, you know what I mean? They stay to themselves, you know what I mean? They don't necessarily want no issues or nothing, you know what I mean? And I have a lot of friends that's Micronesian, you know what I mean? Actually what I do is I go to the park after this, you know what I mean? And I end up giving the children a bunch of free lemonades, you know what I mean? So it's a lovely thing, man, you know what I mean? I love them, actually, that's what.
Hey, we love you, man. So look, man, our culture, we don't hate no race at all. You know what I'm saying? We show nothing but love to any race, you feel me? So first of all, man, I kept on sipping on this, whatever this is. This is great. So what do you call it?
Like I said before, it's Kalan's Kicking Creation. You know what I mean? Kalan's Kicking Creation. So
hey, if y'all want to come down to Waikiki, y'all want Kalan Creations, where can we see you at? What time?
You can find me at Kalan right here at Hilton's Hawaiian Village. Basically anytime between 4 to 9. But we can make it even earlier most of the days, you know what I mean? Monday through Sunday, you know what I mean? So and you can also find us on Instagram at Kalan's_kicking_creation, excuse me. Or Facebook, Kalan's Kicking Creation.
Facts. That feels like it's healing me in the inside, you feel me? And I'm not that kind of guy. Everybody should know, like, I'm not the kind of guy to make bullshit up. You feel me? So, y'all come down here to Waikiki. Find my mans here.
My name is Nafis. And one more time, this is called Kalan's Kicking Creation after my 7-year-old son.
I like that. I love that, man. And loyalty is the most powerful thing in this world, in my opinion. You agree?
Hands down. I named my son after him. His name is Loyal, period.
Yeah, you know I might have to name my son after him.
Yeah, man. Yeah, that's what it is. Feels like some surfing fly.